Hello everyone, today we will see calculation of 1 molar HCl from the stock solution, that is from the main bottle of concentrated HCl which is given. So for this, first of all we know that these informations are written over the bottle. What are these? Molecular weight. So molecular weight of HCl is 36.5 grams per ml. Then density will be written over the bottle. So density will be equal to 1.18 grams per cubic centimeter. And one more thing will be mentioned on the bottle of the concentrated acids which we use in the practicals, that is percentage SA. Percentage SA is equal to 37%. What does this mean? That this particular bottle, the composition of HCl in this bottle is 37%. Okay. Now here we don't know the molarity of the HCl solution given. So first we need to calculate the molarity. How we calculate the molarity? See, 1 molar HCl we want to calculate, and we want to calculate say for 1000 ml. Okay. How much grams of this HCl is to be dissolved? But here we don't have the weight of HCl, but it is in the liquid form. So we have to first convert this volume, this grams into volume, because itself the HCl given is in the liquid form. Okay. On the bottle it is mentioned all these three informations. Other than this also information is given. So first we have to convert the grams into volume. So how can we convert that? We know the equation. Density is equal to mass upon volume. So volume will be equal to mass upon density. Mass of HCl, that is molar mass, is 36.5 and density is 1.18. This gives you 30.9 ml. So this means 30.9 ml in terms of grams, if you take, it is 36.5. Now we convert this in terms of volume, it is around 30.9 ml. What does this means? This means that in the given bottle, that is 1 molar HCl, for around 37% composition, it consists of 30.9 ml of HCl. For 37% SA, it is around 30.9 ml of the HCl 1 molar. Now for 100% SA, how much it will become? It will be equal to 30.9 into 100 divided by 37. This gives you almost equal to 83.5 ml. Okay. So now what does this indicate? This indicates that 83.5 ml of the HCl is to be dissolved in 1000 ml of distilled water, which gives you 1 molar HCl. So now we have our factor, that is for preparation of 1 molar HCl, 1 liter or 1000 ml, we require 83.5 ml of that concentrated HCl. Okay. So when we take 83.5 ml of that concentrated HCl from the bottle directly and dissolve it to 1 liter solution, we get 1 molar solution. So this is our factor. Now from this factor we can calculate as many say as much molar we require or as much volume we require, right? This factor first we have to calculate, because it is in liquid form, we need to calculate that in this manner. Would it have been in the solid form, we would directly write here the grams. So molarity 1000 ml, this many grams, it gives you the required volume and required molarity. But it was in liquid form, so we first converted into a solid, that is how much equivalent volume it is present, and then we determine the factor. Now if we want to calculate, say 0.1 molar HCl, okay, and 1000 ml of that solution we want to prepare, how much ml of that concentrated HCl is to be taken? 8.35 ml. okay, so whatever number it is given, now you can calculate. Say if we require 0.1 molar HCl, 250 ml, so that will be divided by 4, so it gives you 2.09 ml. okay, so if you remember this factor, 1 molar 1000 ml is equal to 83.5, you can calculate any number of or molars or molar volume of the HCl, right? Say you can calculate for 0.5 molar or you can calculate for 0.05 molar or for 500 ml, whatever is given in the question, you can determine based on this. Okay, so this is the method to calculate the volume of HCl required for preparing 1 molar HCl from the stock solution. Now if we don't want to do this, two steps can be combined into one step, that is using one step formula also we can determine the term. That is, the equation given is, say, volume required that is to be taken in ml. Directly you can use this equation also to calculate the volume, how much volume of HCl you have to take to make it 1000 ml 1 molar or whatever molarity is asked. So volume required in ml you have to write into percentage of solution, percentage of solution that will be equal to molarity into molar mass into required volume, how much you want to prepare. But required volume is equal, it is to be taken in decimeter cube, divided by density. Okay, now suppose we want to calculate here, say volume in ml, percentage of solution it is given, that is on the bottle it is written 37%, so we write 37/100. Molarity, we require 1 molar, what we want to prepare. So 1 molar we want to prepare, molar mass is 36.5, required volume in decimeter cube. Now what we have taken is 1 molar, we want to prepare 1000 ml. So 1000 ml means equal to 1000 centimeter cube, or it is equal to 1 decimeter cube. Okay, this factor you can remember, 1000 centimeter cube is equal to 1 decimeter cube. Okay, so here we write, we require 1000 ml, so that will be equal to 1 decimeter cube, so we write into 1, divided by the density that is also mentioned on the bottle, 1.18. So volume, how much you have to take to prepare 1 molar 1000 ml, V in ml is equal to 1 into 36.5 into 1, or we write directly into 100, divided by 37 into 1.18. So directly you will get this equation what we have done in these two steps, okay, that is 36.5 divided by 1.18 and then dividing it by 37, right? So you get directly in one step using this formula, okay? So on calculating, you get the answer as near about to 83.6 ml. So this much volume of HCl is to be dissolved in 1000 ml distilled water. That means you have to add this concentrated HCl into this 1000 ml of the water taken in the volumetric or in the flask, right? So you get 1 molar HCl. So either way you can do, either the first method by using two steps, or you can use this equation. Okay, using this equation also, you can directly calculate the volume required to prepare the given molar concentrated HCl. Thank you.